Hello, hello friends, Danvin here. Let's quickly get into the all the circuits and connections of the cerebellum. Now this entire thing, you take it as a cerebellum. Now see, cerebellum has got two inputs. One input is here and one input is here. Okay, the first input is coming from inferior olivary nucleus and the second input is coming from the spinal cord. Remember, the inputs are usually excitatory. Now inferior olivary nucleus, see, it is excitatory to both the deep nucleus and also the Purkinje cells. Now here also spinal cord input which is coming is excitatory to the granules and also excitatory to the deep nucleus. Now one important concept I would like to share it here. See, these are all the cells: Purkinje, stellate, basket, Golgi and granules. These are the nucleus. The cells are superficial, the nucleus are deep, and the nucleus, the mnemonic to remember is DEFG, that is dentate, embolform, fastigial and globus. The nucleus are deep, the cells are superficial. Got that concept here, right? Now see, this input which is coming here, right, it is excited to Purkinje cells and it is excited to deep nucleus. But you should remember that the Purkinje cells also controls the deep nucleus, and that is always inhibitory. That is inhibitory. Now I told you the cells are always superficial. The second important feature of all these cells, the output from these cells is usually inhibitory. Okay, the cells are usually inhibitory. See, it's always inhibitory except the output from granule cells, which is excitatory. See, granule cell excites all these cells, but the output which are coming from all these cells are inhibitory to the Purkinje cell. Okay, and further, the output from the Purkinje cell is also inhibitory to the deep nucleus. Got the concept clear, right? Now this first input which is coming from inferior nucleus is called as climbing fibers. The second input coming from spinal cord is usually a spinocerebellar tract, is called as mossy fibers. Now this output from the granule cell, which is excitatory, which is only excitatory cell, now it is arranged in parallel manner. Okay, that looks like a letter T. Okay, it looks like letter T, so it's called as a T fibers or parallel fibers. So you got three types of fibers: climbing fibers, mossy fibers and T fiber or parallel fiber. You got a deep nucleus. Okay, the mnemonic for the deep nucleus is DEFG, dentate, embolform, fastigial and globus. You got the cells Purkinje, stellate, basket, Golgi and granule cells. Next thing you have to remember is whether it is positive or negative. Look at this, inferior olivary nucleus is positive to both Purkinje and deep nucleus. Spinal cord, the fibers coming from here is also positive for granule cells and deep nucleus. Okay, and all the output from the cells are usually inhibitory, is always inhibitory. Okay, but the output from the granule cell is excitatory, and that is called as parallel fibers or T fibers.